One day I bumped into this big shot TV guy I know. He said, I'm really desperate. Would you like to host a show? I says, I'm kinda busy here saving the world from crime. But if the money's right, then buddy, show me where to sign.
Show him where to sign.
I knew I'd need some co-hosts or I would surely fail. I remembered I had Brak and Zorak locked up in my jail.
Hello.
I told them all about the show. They were happy as can be.
Yeah, right.
The show is Cartoon Planet and the rest is history.
Re.
Cartoon Planet starring me.
And me.
And me.
Oh boy, am I tired.
Well, did you get a good night's sleep last night?
Well, if you call getting up every half hour and throwing up a good night's sleep, then yes, I had a wonderful night.
What, are you sick?
I got a sour belly.
What did you eat last night?
Well, I had some pizza from this place I used to work at, but I don't think it was that.
Wasn't that the place where the owner's son was going to beat you up for telling his mom he was drunk?
Yes.
My kind of fella.
Well, was this certain guy working last night?
You mean Doug? No, his mom was there, though.
Really? How's she doing?
Oh, she's hanging in there, you know, not bad.
Boy, that sounded bad. You should go home. You know, disease runs rampant around the office. Hey, wait a minute. Zorak, weren't you sick last week?
Well, yeah.
And didn't I see you sneezing and hacking all over Brak?
Sure, but...
Well, there you go.
Are you trying to tell me it's Zorak's fault? You big dummy! You said it wasn't contagious.
Oh, well, that's just fine. Now I have to quarantine the studio. We're all going to have to spend the week here, Zorak. You, me, Brak, the crew.
All right. Sleep over!
Oh, well, now I'm sorry I did it.
Yes. Well, you just think about that while you share a nice, cozy sleeping bag with Brak.
Oh, come on!
See? I can be a little demon, too. Oh, nuts.
Oh, nuts is right. Wait till you throw up pizza.
Ew, I want to see that.
You sicko. Let's do some reading. Dear Space Ghost, I really like you, and I like when you zap Zorak. Luke Case, Ketchup, Alaska. Alrighty. Dear Space Ghost, I watch your show all the time. I love it when you zap Zorak. Could you zap him for me? Chris Obermeyer. Okie dokie. Continuing. Dear Space Ghost, I think you should zap Zorak billions in trillions of times. Your pal, Chris Leffel, incoming! Yada yada, please shoot Zorak with your power band. Yada yada, remember to zap Zorak.
What I do to this?
Boy, it's getting hot in here.
Dear Space Ghost, blabbity blabbity blah, blast Zorak, and so forth and so on. Blast Zorak. Okay, hunker down, Harriet. Whoops.
What's the problem?
I'm out of juice. No need to worry, though. I'm off to get recharged.
Oh, all right. Take your time. I'm going down to the river. Honey, that's where I'll be. Gonna hold my nose and jump right in, 'cause you don't care about me. Take me to the river, where the water's dark and deep. I'll be down where the fishes sleep, 'cause you don't care about me. You don't care about me. You don't care about me. Going to the river to take a dip, 'cause baby, you just don't give a flip.
Hey.
gonna go out tonight where the lights are bright and find a new bug friend. And we'll go down to the river, and you know I'll jump for joy when she looks at me with those great big eyes and says, Zorak, you're my boy.
Here's a wonderful nugget of joy from Zorak.
We've all heard the expression, it's as easy as taking candy from a baby. But have you ever thought about how accurate that expression actually is? I mean, think about it. Babies offer practically no resistance, and they are easily distracted. Simply say, hey, baby, look at the nice doggy over there. Then snatch the candy from their teeny little fingers and head for the...
Zorak!
What?
That is simply despicable, encouraging viewers to take candy from babies.
Well, I mean, candy's not good for babies. It's, bad for their teeth.
So what you're saying is, when you take candy from a little bitty baby...
I'm doing him a favor for crying out loud.
Oh, come on. Babies don't even have teeth.
They don't? I mean, I know they don't. And you know why? Because they eat too much candy.
When I was in high school one time, I was voted homecoming king. My mom said, oh, what an honor. And she made me a beautiful king outfit, which I wore to the homecoming dance. I was there for about 3 hours when I realized I didn't know even one single person. I must be going to the wrong school, I cried out. But I figured, you know, these guys had voted me king, so they were my loyal subjects. So I stayed at the dance till long after it was over. And I taxed them heavily. The end.
It's time for Vacation Spots of the Universe. Today we visit the Flying Island. Ah, yes, the lovely Flying Island, where you'll enjoy breathtaking views of mountains and flower gardens. Feel free to smell the roses, but watch out for those pesky vampire plants. There's a 4-star hotel with all the modern amenities, including extra-large microwave ovens. Be careful, that's hot! The Flying Island is constantly moving across the map, so it's bound to be near you sooner or later. Rockets are taking off now. Just call and you'll find one of our friendly operators ready to take your reservations. You might even get a chance to see the reclusive Mist Dragon, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. But make sure you don't park your jet too close. And don't forget, there's some of the most exciting monster wrestling around here on the island. You can even have it piped into the closed-circuit TV in your hotel room, which also shows lots of old Ultra 7 episodes. Then, enjoy the nighttime fireworks show. There's always plenty of free parking, even a valet tractor beam. Watch for the Flying Island in a galaxy near you.
I had this dream once that I went to Earth, and I was walking around on the street, and I came up to this policeman who was, you know, standing on the corner. He said, what are you doing? And I said, I think I'm lost. And he said, well, where do you live? And I said, I live up there. And I pointed up in the sky, and he, like, took his hat off and scratched his head. He said, you're an alien, aren't you? And I said, I don't know, I guess. And then I woke up. They say that breaking up, it's hard to do. Now I know that it's true. All you ever do is bring me down, down, down. Turn my happy smile into a frown, frown, frown. You keep on telling me that you'll be leaving soon. Well, don't let the front door hit on the backside when you do. Don't let the front door hit on the backside when you leave. You're finally through and there's no boo-hooing from me. I'll find myself somebody new who like me cause I'm me. And I'll be good to her too, yes it is. And we'll live happily ever after. The end.
Roses are red, roses are blue. It's time for Poet's Corner.
Yahoo!
Here's a poem by Alfred Lord Tennyson, anyone?
Oh, oh, oh! Well, for the fisherman's boy that he shouts with his sister at play. Oh, well, for the sailor lad that he sings in his boat on the bay. Break, break, break at the foot of thy crags, O sea. But the tender grace of the day that is dead will never come back to me.
Hey, Brak, what does that poem mean?
The poem speaks of a yearning for that which is lost. A hunger for something to eat.
Nothing works up an appetite in the old Space Ghost more than a couple stanzas of classical verse.
Boy, howdy.
Corned beef would be good right now. I just happen to know, don't ask me how, that Alfred Lord Tennyson ate corned beef and sauerkraut morning, noon, and night. That's why his nickname was Reuben. Reuben Lord Tennyson, and his buddies would say, hey, Reuben, write another poem, buddy. And then he'd say, okay, but let me finish my sandwich first. Mashed potatoes. Hey, sweet potatoes. Baked potatoes. Potato chips. Whoa, smoked sausage.
Fried
chicken, pepperoni pizza, tenderloin chips. Nobody can make a donut do the things you do. Believe me, baby, believe me, baby. I've tried quite a few. I've eaten meatballs in Sweden and pork chops in Peru. All it did was remind me of you, baby. And your mashed potatoes, sweet potatoes. Oh, baby, pass the butter.
Zorak, I'm receiving a transmission from Earth. It's from Count Floyd.
Oh, well, let's hear what the old bat has to say.
Hi, kids. Count Floyd here. Let's all do the official Count Floyd vampire howl. Oh! Hey, what's going on here? Pay attention. What is that over there, huh?
I was just showing everybody the Mr. Floyd doll my mom made. See?
It's Count Floyd, all right? Not Mr. Floyd. And what is this? Ooh, well, that's interesting. It's so lifelike and so... well, dead-like. Ooh, boy, I bet you enjoy playing with this doll, huh?
Yeah. Count Floyd captures Raggedy Ann. Mm-hmm. Then Raggedy Andy comes to rescue her by driving a wooden stake into Count Floyd's chest.
Oh, that's sick. I never... Oh, that, you take that thing. What do you think this is anyway? Show and tell with those things? Well, speaking of... telling, I'm going to tell you people a scary story. You're in for another super scary one from the Monster Chiller book. Ooh, boy, and it's a good one. See, it's all about this creepy island called Caruca del Sol. It's an island paradise and playland getaway. What is this? A travel brochure. What am I supposed to do with this? Yeah. Oh, well, kids... ooh, these pamphlets, they can get pretty scary, too. You know, with the high prices in here. Ooh, Caruca del Sol, island of voodoo and black magic and walking zombie-type dead guys.
Once upon a creepy time, a guy was shipwrecked on a scary island.
Oh, and his wife was with him too. And they were attacked by head-hunting, cannibal-type zombies. The zombies took the couple to the haunted cave of monster chiller tiki gods, where they performed the scary witchcraft ritual of the hedge-raker cannibals of living voodoo death.
What's voodoo?
Well, voodoo, that's that spooky island stuff, you know, where they put a magic spell on a doll, and whatever happens to that doll happens to the person. Ooh. Anyway, what happened was the cannibals, they carved up a little wooden doll, see? And they, the doll looked like the man. Only it wasn't funny. It was scary. Oh, that tickles. It tickles. Oh, wait a minute. So where was I? Why? Hold it. Come on, what's going on here? Watkins, come on, cut it out! Cut it out!
Ew, it's mushed!
I told you that voodoo stuff was really scary.
That's it. I've lost the signal. Don't fret, kiddies. Count Floyd will be back next week. Now it's time for the Cartoon Planet Storybook. Today's story is called Lead Bunny. It was written by Kaylee Courtney. I am a ballerina. I am 6 years old. These are my shoes. Last week, I got to be in a recital. My class did the bunny dance. And guess what? I got to be the lead bunny. Madam Helga, my teacher, taught me how to hop out on stage. All the bunnies hopped right behind me. We had big ears and fuzzy tails. On the night of the recital, my mom put lipstick and rouge on all the bunnies, even the boys. It was funny.
Oh, that's so funny. What did you say?
When we went to do the dance, I started hopping before the music. I was the only bunny on stage. Madam Helga was yelling and waving her arms. All the other bunnies hopped out on stage to get away from Madam Helga.
Madam Helga, ruff, ruff, ruff.
After the recital, my mom and dad gave me a trophy with a ballerina on it. But they won't let me go back to Madam Helga's class. The end. What a sappy little story that was.
Do you think Madam Helga is available?
Available? For what?
Oh, you know, a little of this, a little of that.
Oh, yeah, right. I'm guessing that Madam Helga just sits by the phone, hoping and praying that a conniving little green insect will give her a jingle.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, too.
Scoop up boom boom midi lidi doo boom.
Zip zap doo bada shibi dee 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 dee.
What happened to that is all?
Super no button dee 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 doo doo.
Zap zap doo dee doo bow wow.
Wow 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 wow.
Scoot li boo li boo li boo li boo zap zoom zap dee dee dee.
Yeah, zap go. Wah yah yah doo wah wah.
I got the music in me.
I've got the music in me.
Wow, wow, what they said.
Go do it,
yeah. Sandwich.
Oh no, a planet in need. This looks like a job for Mr. Big Tough Guy, Space Ghost. He's so powerful. How can they ever stop him? So, faithful viewers, Space Ghost raises his mighty power bands and...
Oh, baby.
Oops, sorry. I got a little carried away. How embarrassing.
Yeah. Don't mention it.
Boom, there you go. Boom, there you go. Boom, there you go.
Are you trying Boom, to be hip again?
Yeah. Boom, there you go. Boom, there you go. Boom,
there you go.
Zorak, what's round on the ends and high in the middle?
Ohio.
No. Oh, hi. Oh, crud. You knew that one. Okay, then. What's no on one end, ta on the other, and Earth Deco in the middle?
You are being goofy now.
No, North Dakota. Whee! That was fun. Okay, now, what's Okla on one end, ma on the other, and Paul in the middle?
You can stop anytime.
All righty. What's Tull on one end, C in the other, and Adult? All right, I'll shut up now.
Swing your partner round and round and go do town. Booty doo doo doo. Now it's time to say goodbye to Zorak and his kin. Thank you folks for kindly doing stuff and dropping in. Ah, have a heap and helping of our hospitality. Goodbye, 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 everybody.